like first of all to read part of a scene from Webster's The Duchess of Malfi. I'm assuming that the plot of this play is known. So even if I knew it myself, I wouldn't have to explain it. A servant comes in and tells the Duchess that she is going to be entertained by some madmen from the local next-door lunatic asylum before she is executed by her sadistic and incestuous brothers. The servant comes in and says, "I am come to tell you your brother hath intended you some sport. A great physician, when the Pope was sick of a deep melancholy, presented him with several sorts of madmen, which wild object, being full of change and sport, forced him to laugh, and so the imposthume broke. The selfsame cure the Duke intends on you." The Duchess says, "Let them come in. There's a mad lawyer and a secular priest, a doctor that hath forfeited his wits by jealousy, an astrologian that in his works said such a day of the month should be the day of doom, and failing it, ran mad. An English tailor crazed in the brain with a study of new fashion, a gentleman usher quite beside himself, with care to keep in mind the number of his lady's salutations, or how do you do, she employed each morning. A farmer, too, an excellent knave in grain, mad because he was hindered transportation. And let one broker that's mad loose to these, you'd think the devil were among them. Sit, Cariola. Let them loose when you please, for I am chained to endure all your tyranny. Here, by a madman, this song is sung to a dismal kind of music. Oh, let us howl some heavy note, some deadly dogged howl, sounding as from the threatening throat of beasts and fatal fowl, as ravens, screech owls, bulls, and bears, we'll bell and bawl our parts till yucksome noise has cloyed your ears and corrosived your hearts. At last, when, as our choir wants breath, our bodies being blessed, we'll sing like swans to welcome death, and die in love and rest." Then the madmen enter. "Doomsday not come yet. I'll draw it nearer by a perspective, or make a glass that shall set all the world on fire upon an instant. I cannot sleep. My pillow is stuffed with a litter of porcupines. Hell is a mere glass house where the devils are continually blowing up women's souls on hollow irons, and the fire never goes out. I will lie with every woman in my parish the tenth night. I will tithe them over like haycocks. Shall my apothecary outgo me because I am a cuckold? I have found out his roguery. He makes alum of his wife's urine and sells it to Puritans that have sore throats with overstraining. I have skill in heraldry. Hast! You do give for your crest a woodcock's head with the brains picked out on it. You are a very ancient gentleman.
Greek is turned Turk. We are only to be saved
by the Helvetian translation. Come on, sir, I will lay the law to you. Or rather, lay a corrosive, the law will eat to the bone. He that drinks but to satisfy nature is damned. If I had my glass here, I would show a sight should make all the women here call me mad doctor. What's he? A rope maker? No, no. A snuffling knave that while he shows the tombs will have his hand in a wench's placket. Woe to the caroach that brought home my wife from the mast. At 3 o'clock in the morning, it had a large feather bed in it. I have pared the devil's nails 40 times, roasted them in raven's eggs, and cured agues with them. Give me 300 milch bats to make posits to procure sleep. All the college may throw their caps at me. I have made a soap boiler costive. It was my masterpiece. Here the dance, consisting of 8 madmen, with music answerable thereunto. After which Bozola, like an old man, enters. Duchess says, is he mad? Question him. I leave you. I am come to make thy tomb. My tomb. Thou speakest of her lips as if I lay upon my deathbed. Dost thou perceive me sick? Yes, and the more dangerously, since thy sickness is insensible. Thou art not mad, sure. Dost know me? Yes. Who am I? Thou art a box of worm seed at best, but a salvatory of green mummy. What's this flesh? A little cruded milk, fantastical puff paste. Our bodies are weaker than those paper prisons boys used to keep flies in. More contemptible since ours is to preserve earthworms. Didst thou ever see a lark in a cage? Such is the soul in the body. This world is like her little turf of grass, and the heaven o'er our heads like her looking glass. Only gives us a more miserable knowledge of the small compass of our prison. Am I not I, thy duchess? Thou art some great woman, sure, for riot begins to sit on thy forehead, clad in grey hairs, 20 years sooner than on a merry milkmaid's. Thou sleepest worse than if a mouse should be forced to take up her lodging in a cat's ear. A little infant that breeds its teeth, should it lie with thee, would cry out as if thou wert the most unquiet bedfellow. I am Duchess of Malfi still. That makes thy sleep so broken. Glories like glowworms afar off shine bright, but looked too near have neither heat nor light. Thou art very plain. My trade is to flatter the dead, not the living. I am a tomb maker. And thou comest to make my tomb? Yes. Let me be a little merry. What stuff wilt thou make it? Nay, resolve me first of what fashion. Why do we grow fantastical in our deathbed? Do we affect fashion in the grave? Most ambitiously. princes' images on their tombs do not lie as they were wont, seeming to pray up to heaven, but with their hands under their cheeks as if they died of the toothache. They are not carved with their eyes fixed upon the stars, but as their minds were wholly bent upon the world, the selfsame way they seem to turn their faces. Let me know fully, therefore, the effect of this thy dismal preparation, this talk fit for a charnel. Now I shall. Enter executioners with a coffin, corpse, and a bell. Here is a present from your princely brothers, and may it arrive welcome, for it brings last benefit, last sorrow. Let me see it. I have so much obedience in my blood, I wish it were their veins to do me good. This is your last presence, chamber. Oh, my sweet lady. I am the common bellman that usually is sent to condemned persons the night before they suffer. Even now thou saidst thou wast a tomb maker. 'Twas to bring you by degrees to mortification. Listen. Hark, now everything is still. The screech owl and the whistler shrill call upon our dame aloud and bid her quickly don her shroud. Much you had of land and rent, your length in clays now competent. A long war disturbed your mind, here your perfect peace is signed. Of what is fools make such vain keeping? In their conception, their birth weeping, their life a general mist of error, their death a hideous storm of terror. Strew your hair with powder sweet, don clean linen, bare your feet, and the foul fiend more to check, a crucifix let bless your neck. Is now full tide, tween night and day. End your groan and come away. Hence, villains, tyrants, murderers, alas, what will you do with my lady? Call for help. To whom? To our next neighbors. They are mad for. Remove that noise. Farewell. In my last will, I have not much to give. A many hungry guests have fed upon me. Thine will be a poor reversion. I will die with her. I pray thee, look thou givest my little boy some syrup for his cold, and let the girl say her prayers ere she sleep. Now, what you please. What death? Strangler, here are your executioners. I forgive them. The apoplexy, catarrh, or cough of the lungs would do as much as they do. Doth not death fright you? Who would be afraid on it, knowing to meet such excellent company in the other world? Yet methinks the manner of your death should much afflict you, the cord should terrify you. Not to quit. What would it pleasure me to have my throat cut with diamonds, or to be smothered with cassia or to be shot to death with pearls. I know death hath 10,000 several doors for men to take their exits, and 'tis found they go on such strange geometrical hinges, you may open them both ways. Anyway, for heaven's sake, so I were out of your whispering. Tell my brothers that I perceive death. Now I am well awake. Best gift is they can give, or I can take. I would fain put off my last woman's fault. I'll not be tedious with you. We are ready. Dispose my breath how please you, but my body bestow upon my women. Yes. Pull and pull strongly, for your able strength must pull down heaven upon me. Yet stay, heaven's gates are not so highly arched as princes' palaces. They that enter there must go upon their knees. Come, violent death, serve for Mandragora to make me sleep. Go tell my brothers when I am laid out, then they may feed in quiet. They strangle her. Where's the waiting woman? Fetch her. Some other strangle the children. Look you, there sleeps your mistress. Oh, you are damned perpetually for this. My turn is next, is it not so ordered? Yes, and I am glad you are so well prepared for it. You are deceived, sir. I have not prepared for it. I will not die. I will come first to my answer and know how I have offended. Come, dispatch her. You kept her counsel. Now you shall keep ours. I will not die. I must not. I am contracted to a young gentleman. Here's your wedding ring. Let me but speak with the Duke. I'll discover treason to his person. Delays. Throttle her. She bites and scratches. If you kill me now, I am damned. I have not been at confession this 2 years. When? I am quick with child. Why then, your credit saved. Bear her into the next room. They strangled her and bear her away. Enter the Duchess's brother, Ferdinand. Is she dead? She is what you'd have her. But here begin your pity. He shows the children strangled. Alas, how have these offended? The death of young wolves is never to be pitied. Fix your eye here constantly. Do you not weep? Other sins only speak. Murder shrieks out. The element of water moistens the earth, but blood flies upwards and bedews the heavens. Cover her face. Mine eyes dazzle. She died.